Thanks for watching TechWiki. Click the subscribe button, then enable notifications with the bell icon so you won't miss any future videos. Now, it used to be that if you were sitting in your car and needed a traffic update, you'd turn on the radio and sometime in the next 10 minutes, someone in a helicopter somewhere would dutifully inform you of the 10-mile traffic backup due to an overturned maple syrup tanker. These days, though, you can get much more extensive, not to mention live, traffic information for over 90 countries on Google Maps. Just tap the traffic icon and the roads you're looking at become color-coded to indicate relative traffic congestion levels. But how does Google pull this off? Does Larry Page truly see and know all, thanks to his huge fleet of helicopters, satellites, or drones? Well, no. You see, Google traffic started out using historical traffic data, which would project how busy a particular road would be based on past trends like day of the week, time of day, and even month of the year. For example, you could be reasonably certain that the 101 in Los Angeles at 5 p.m. on a weekday would be busier than Route 912 west of Bennettsville, South Carolina at 2 in the morning. Or, well, ever. But obviously, that was an imperfect solution because it couldn't inform drivers of real-time conditions, like if a normally free-flowing road was suddenly blocked by a traffic accident, road construction, or a flock of Canada geese. Fast forward a bit to when everyone and their mother started buying shiny new location-aware smartphones, and the game totally changed. In 2007, Google decided, well, hey, why not just see how many phones are on the road and use that to estimate how much traffic is on it? Today, though, Google traffic actually uses a combination of GPS tracking and measuring the signal delay between each smartphone and nearby cell phone towers to figure out where your car is. The latter method was originally developed to allow cell carriers to know what service area you were in so they could charge you for roaming. But now it does something that's actually helpful. Neat. But hold on a second. How does Google traffic offer those alerts that tell you about accidents or road work? Well, a lot of that is actually handled through Waze, an app that crowdsources reports on road blockages, construction zones, and even police speed traps. Waze was bought by Google in 2013, and while it still exists as an independent app, many of its features and data have been integrated into Google traffic. As for the road incidents that crowdsourcing doesn't catch, Google traffic also gets reports from the local government agencies responsible for transportation, which can be particularly helpful for relaying official updates for long-term road closures, like the one down the street from our office all summer. Anyway, it's a huge time saver to be rerouted around accidents and all of that stuff. But all of this vehicle tracking raises some fairly obvious privacy concerns. Does Google have a huge database of every trip you've taken since buying a smartphone? Well, Google says that it permanently deletes information about the origins and destinations of your journeys, but to my knowledge, no one has ever independently audited this. So, the easiest solution, if this makes you uncomfortable, is to turn off location services on your phone if you don't want to be part of the massive Google machine. Especially useful if you don't want ads tailored to the seedy establishments that you frequent, you deviant you. And speaking of frequenting places, are you frequently racing against the clock as a freelancer? This episode is brought to you by FreshBooks. I mean, it's tough being a small business owner, especially when you work all day at whatever it is you do. Let's say you run a small home repair firm, or you do computer upgrades on the side. You don't want to spend all day doing that and then go home and fight with complicated accounting software. FreshBooks lets you be more productive, more organized, and perhaps most importantly, get paid more quickly. You can create and send professional-looking invoices in less than 30 seconds, and you can even see once the client has opened it. You can set up online payments with just a couple of clicks and get paid up to 4 days faster. You can get paid on your terms with the ability to take deposits directly through the platform, and you can track things like the hours you spent on a job and your expenses when you're on the go with the fully featured app for iOS and Android. So don't take my word for it. Try it out. There's a 30-day free trial for our viewers. Go to freshbooks.com/techquickie and enter techquickie in the How Did You Hear About Us section. So thanks for watching, guys. Dislike or like, check out our other channels, leave a comment with video suggestions, and subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss any future Tech Quickies.